This conference will now be recorded. This conference will now be recorded.
So in next half an hour, we will discuss, we will open for the discussions, and we will take your questions and answers, right? So we do not waste more time, because we're already running late. It's almost, we lost 15 minutes. So we'll start and we'll try to finish ASAP with some slides and basic knowledge about Agile and Scrum. What is Agile and what is Scrum? So sometimes some people say that Agile is a methodology. Excuse me, everybody able to listen to me? I'm audible?
Yes, you are audible.
So most of the time we listen about that agile is a methodology, but I also have a guru, and he always told me that agile is not a methodology. It's agile is working on some principle and values, and it's a combination of this principle and values, and on this agile which has some principle and values, different framework is working. Like Scrum is one, XP is another one, then Kanban is the another framework, then safe, we can say when we move to the scale, then safe is there, then dead. Yes, there are so many different framework available there which works on agile values and principles. So it's not a methodology, it's a combination of some principles and values. So I will go through with the slides, will explain you a little about the Agile and Scrum, and then we will open for the forum. Okay. Just a minute, guys. Can't able to move it. Okay. So we'll leave this part. So I think this is the approach which we follow right now, that we'll go to the lecture, then exercise, then question answer. Today we'll go with the lecture, and then we'll start with question and answer and a little part of discussions. So we'll discuss about what and why Agile, and discussion about the Agile framework, Agile, the different frameworks on Agile, the Scrums and different rules of the Scrums, and Kanban we've left. We will not discuss about Kanban today. So what is the first we'll discuss about what is the benefit of Agile, then step by step we will explain you. I will explain you. So for example, what is the traditional view of of the product management is that identify the customer needs, then establish target specification, high level requirement, which is BA will participate and create the high level requirement, then development functional SRS is there, then development will start, and after that after coding has finished, then testing is in the testing phase will come. So what happened when we in this traditional view, what happened, the customer we discuss, customer will participate from first phase where BA will discuss and try to understand what are the requirement, and after in the UAT phase. So you can say then when coding phase has finished, so everything will be green. What happened when testing start, then only this will come in, the issues will be in the picture, right? So there we will try to understand what are the issues, then the status will change from green to amber or red. So this is the traditional view of product management, how in the waterfall model. You can see the what I discussed, this requirement gathering, architecture design, and coding complete, and then we start with the testing. So this is the sequential series. So because testing is in the last, and we are found that what are the different issues we are facing, and at that time 80% of time already has finished. If there is if we found some issues in testing, what happened at that time we can't able to deliver our product on time. So in this issue, we have to take some decisions that what we need to do now. We have to increase our time, So we have to discuss with the customer, okay, we have to increase our time. If we will increase our time, then the financial issues are there. And if we will, you know, if we'll discuss with the customer, okay, we have to drop some requirements or some features. In this issue, the quality will be the issue. So this is the approach in the traditional approach. And what happened in the Agile, because Agile is working in the iteration mode, right? Everybody, I think the basic knowledge everybody has that iteration, Agile says that every we have to develop everything in the iteration. It has a small part in which we develop everything from, you know, requirement understanding to testing. So in this Agile approach, everything is easy to understand to the customer. So this will give the financial crunch, you know, remove the financial crunch also, plus the business value also provide in the Agile methodology. So we'll go through this. And I think, so as I discussed with you, this you'll be able to see that we'll start, then analysis, then design, then code and test. The year we will find all the defects, as I discussed in the waterfall model. So if you find last the issues, then this will cost a lot to the client because it is in the last phase of the development. But you understand what I'm saying, right? So already discussed. So so what happened in the water in the waterfall model? Because, you know, client we interact with client in the first phase and then after the last phase. Then what happened? Because most of because there is no discussion with the client. So what happened? 45% of your requirement, which we have developed in the waterfall model, is never used. 19% is rarely used. 16% is you know, sometimes used, and 30% is often used, but always used is 7%. So you can see from this chart that so maximum 20% of total requirement out of 100. 100%, only 20% is used most of the time. So you see the 80% of work which we have done to develop in waterfall model is totally waste of time, totally waste of money. Time for client and money for client, because it's not going to hurt the companies, but it's going to hurt the client. So 80% of feature never used. And so it's totally waste of time and money. So this is the issues with the issues with the waterfall model or the traditional model. You can see there the cost of change of curve. Now we come to the Agile. As I discussed, Agile is so Agile removed three type of risk. So two I already discussed with you. One is the business risk, another one is the financial risk. So financial, because we develop our project in iteration mode. So after every iteration, we deliver something to the client. It's called client able to understand that we are in which direction. So if we are in the right direction, then he give us input every time, and he able to understand that we are in the right direction. My money is in is using in the right direction, right? And the business value, because, you know, for example, we are working in some banking type of application. So, you know, the banking market is financial market is changing very fast, rapidly. So in this case, what happened if we work in the traditional model, might be we'll finish our project in 1.5 year. And then after that time, the product is right. Whatever customer has told us, we have developed in the same way. But after 1.5 hour might be the you know, market has totally changed. And at that time, there is no use to this type of product. But if we work in the Agile mode, because it moving in a small iteration, so if there is a change, then customer easily told us that or tell us that, okay, these are the changes which you have to implement in product. So now we will discuss a little about the Agile manifesto. Agile, what Agile, these are the different values of the Agile. We have total four different values for the Agile. One is the individual and interactions, work process and tools. Another one is working software over comprehensive documentation. So Agile says this working software is more important compared to documentation. It's not says that you have not create any document, but working software, which we choose every time to the client, is more effective compared to the documentation. Customer collaboration over customer negotiation. The customer relationship with the customer should be very high. We have to customer participation is very important every time. So we have to in the tight communication with the customer. The respond to change, as I discussed with you guys, that if there is a change in the product, in the project, because of rapid change in the market, so in agile methodology, in agile way of working, it is very it is easy to adapt these type of changes, and implement is very easy compared to the traditional model. So these are the different 12 principles of the agile, and I will you know, go through it very fast. I just read it, and we'll take it later. If there is anything important, then I will explain you. So our highest priority is to satisfy the customer through early and continuous delivery of valuable software. As I suggest you that it, I discuss with you, because we work in the iteration of 2 weeks, 3 weeks. So most of the time we work in the 2 weeks. So every time we have to deliver something after 2 weeks, welcome changing requirements, even late in development, discuss if there is a change in the project or in the product as per the market requirement. So in agile, it's very easy to, you know, take these type of changes. Delivery working software frequently from a couple of weeks to months. I already discussed with you. Business people and development must work together daily throughout the project. So interaction with the client is in fact in some projects we have discussed every day in the evening. We have a call with the client and we will discuss what we did, what we are going to do tomorrow, and what we have developed today. So the communication is very important in the agile. Build project around motivational individuals. So we have to support our team every time, and we will provide them environment that they will, you know, the output will be very high and with the quality work. The most efficient and effective method of conveying information to and within a development team is face-to-face conversation. So agile suggests that message, you know, face-to-face conversation will be there. Like PO is their product owner, and we have product owner is a part of the team, but he represent client. So face-to-face conversation should be there every time. Working software is the primary measure of the progress. As I discussed, agile process promotes sustainable development. Sponsor developers and the user should be able to maintain a constant pace indefinitely. Okay. Continuous attention to technical excellence and good design enhance agility. Simplicity, the art of maximize the amount of work not done. Okay. The best architecture requirement and design emerge with self-organizing teams. So agile always says that as the development team should be, you know, self-motivating and self-discipline, and the team should be very disciplined. And if the team is self-organizing, then the work is easy. All other people who is in the Scrum team should be support the development team, right? And try to be as much as self-organized and you know, self-confident team. Then they will work better, they will perform better, and the quality work will be there. At regular intervals, the team reflect on how to become more effective, then use and gets its behavior accordingly. Because there are so many different type of agile suggest ceremonies is there. So in this case, you know, we always discuss about our work within the team, that how if there is any impediments, is there any issues, we will able to discuss within the team, and we'll try to solve everything within the team. So these are different principles and values on which agile is working. And different framework, you know, we have created on which will work on agile with these principles and their own, you know, values and principle. So today we're going to discuss about Scrum. Same. Okay, the agile methods are designed to produce the first delivery in weeks to achieve an early win and rapid feedback. So agile suggests us that as early as you will get the feedback. So it suggests as early as you will fail. As early as you know, you will correct everything, because you know, in first iteration or in 2-3 iteration, if you know, we will take feedback from client. So this will be an advantage. If we will doing something wrong, then you know, client will suggest us, okay, I do not want you. Might be there is some issue to understand the requirement, or might be there is other type of issues also. But if we will in the discussion with the client, with every after every iteration, which is a short time iteration. If the project is very new, in some projects we will take only 1 week of iteration. So if there is only 1 week of iteration, So after every week, we will take feedback from the client. And this, so it is a very rapid feedback. In this case, if we say that we can't able to achieve our goal, might be a customer wants something else and we deliver something else. So in this case, we fail early because the client tell us after a week that, okay, I do not want this type of thing. But so here you can understand the difference between the agile and the traditional method. In traditional methodology might be client will tell us after 6 or 7 months that, okay, I do not want these type of product or project. This was not my requirement. So here you can understand within a week, be able to understand what client want from us. So rapid feedback is very important in agile. Invent simple solutions so there is less to change and making. Improve design quality continuously. Always there is so many discussions within the team. So quality will be increased if there is an issue with the code or there is an issue with the testing or anything else. So because we have discussed every time in the team, so these things will improve time by time, and because quality will increase, so changes will be less or failure will be less. And test continuously. So agile always suggests that it is not like the traditional model that we will test after everything is developed. We will start our testing as soon as the sprint will, iteration will start. I think it is very much similar. It's nothing else. Have we already discussed about that? So in agile, as I discussed with you guys, lightweight approaches or fuller approaches. Fuller approaches is lightweight is Scrum, Lean, Kanban, Crystal, and XP. And fuller approaches is dynamic system development method, agile unified process, or the scaled agile. When we work on the large scale where the team size is more than 60 or 70 people, and where we have created more than 6 teams. So when we handle these team, so this is will be in the scaled agile part. Otherwise, lightweight approaches is Scrum, Lean, where a team is not more than 2-3. So Scrum at a glance. So as I discuss, we'll explain. We're going to explain in the this chart. So input from end user, customer, team, and other stakeholders on the behalf of these, and the product owner is also there. Product owner will take all the requirements and everything, discuss with the stakeholders and the customers, and after taking these requirements, is going to create user stories for the particular sprint or for the product actually, and he will keep all these user stories in the backlog. And team is there, we will say this is the Scrum team, and the PO, product owner, Scrum master, and development team is the part of the Scrum team. Then we will do the sprint planning, and in sprint planning we will discuss with the PO, where we will discuss about the definition of ready, that what type of user stories we are going to take, and what is the criteria we will define in the definition of ready, that if the user story will go through with this criteria, and if able to pass this criteria, only we will going to take the user stories. Then definition of done is there, that if user story has completed, then again user story has to pass the definition of done process, then only we will accept that user story has completed. So in the first phase, we will discuss about DOR and DOD and the team. We will develop our team. It's a cross-functional team. Everybody should be there. What type of people we need. So the all person should be in the team. PO is there and Scrum Master is there. Then sprint planning. We will in the sprint planning meeting, we will discuss with the PO what are the priority of the work. According to the priority, we will take user stories. And we will move these user story in the sprint, and we will in the sprint, and we will discuss about the user stories. If we have any question, anything else which we want to know about the user story, these all things we will discuss in the sprint planning meeting, and we will start our working. So after we start this, daily Scrum is there, and also one thing I forget about to tell you, that sprint in the sprint planning we have to define our sprint goal. And that's every sprint has some goal, every sprint has some scope. So we have to define our goal and our scope in the sprint planning meeting. Also, this is the very important thing, because if there is no goal, then how can, because you know, in Agile or in Scrum, we are not working as individual, we are working as a team. So if we're working as a team, so every team has a goal that after 15 days or after 2 weeks of a sprint, what we are going to deliver. The goal is there and the scope is there. Then every day daily Scrum has happened just for 15 minutes in which we will discuss about, okay, what the person has did, what the person did yesterday and what is going to do today and if there is any impediments. So please understand that all ceremonies, whatever we are discussing here, the sprint planning, the daily Scrum or the sprint review or the sprint retrospective, everything is time box work. Why they are time, these ceremonies are time box. For example, daily Scrum is there. If it is suggested by the Scrum that it's Scrum aligns that it should not be more than 15 minutes. The reason behind that, because if the people is in discussion there, that whatever impediment is there and they start discussing there, might be this will take half an hour, 45 minutes, and some person is standing there just waiting to their turn just to explain what he has did, what he did yesterday and what is going to do today, and if there is an impediment, and we almost lose 1 hour just to discuss everything. So or might be this person do not have any impediment, he just give us just tell about status and he just finish everything and is going to for his work. So that's why everything is time boxed, and Scrum Align suggests, okay, if you have any impediments, you have to take it offline. The meaning offline that if you once finish with your daily Scrum and then you will discuss with the other people. So we are going to save the time. The time is the key in Scrum, because every sprint is from 2 to 4 weeks. And in today's scenarios, in most of the organization, it is only for 2 weeks. So time is the key. We'll discuss everything and we will waste our time. And how can we achieve our goal? Then we will do the review. And review, the meaning of the sprint review is we can say it's a sprint demo where we will show our work to the stakeholders. It's not a very official type of thing. It just sit everybody will sit there and show that what we have achieved in the sprint, and be able to try to create some shippable product incrementally. Why we say this is incremental? Because in every sprint, in every iteration, we will deliver something. So it is in this increment way. And after that, we finish with our review. We will go to the retro. In retro, we will discuss within the team that what we did good in sprint, what went well, what went wrong, and what we have to improve. Then we will find out the actionable item, and we will discuss about our actionable item and these actionable item, we will find, might be there is 5-6 things which. On which team wants to work, and we will suggest the team that okay, you will find out 2-3 things which is very important, and every day in the daily Scrum we need to discuss about these 2-3 actionable item which we find out in the retro, okay, and try to work on these actionable item which will help us to improve in our quality and in our product delivery. So as I told you, Scrum is time boxed. If we have 2 weeks of sprint, then as suggested by the Scrum Alliance, our sprint planning should not be more than 4 hours, and daily Scrum should not be more than 15 minutes. Our sprint reviews should be between 1 and 1.5 hours, and retro is also between 1 and 1.5 hours. So there is 4 ceremonies, official ceremonies there. One is daily Scrum, another one is sprint planning, third one is a sprint review, fourth one is the sprint retrospective. One is unofficial, but I say that is very important. It's the soul of the whole Scrum process, which is the product backlog refinement. We'll discuss about these things. So there are different rules, as I told you. One is Scrum Master, Product Owner, and the development team. it's so I think now the whole team is called as a Scrum team, and the people, the combination of QA, different SMEs and the developers is called our development team. So so Scrum Master role is there, and the role of Scrum Master is more, it's a facilitator, it's a servant leader, you can say. You know, Scrum Master has different type of role. For example, if team is very new, and in the beginning, he should be a mentor who will teach the team that how to work, how, what is the benefit of the Agile, how we will work on the Scrum, what are the, what are the benefit of the different ceremonies, how we will do these type of ceremonies, and why we deliver everything, why iteration is there, and why we deliver things in the sprint manner or in this increment way. And then if team is a little mature, then he will be in the form, his role has been changed to the coach, then he will coach the team, not mentor. And then he try to make team self organized, self confident, self and disciplined team. So Scrum Master role is more facilitator, and he is a servant leader. Sometimes he has to lead from the front, he has to protect the team, and sometimes he behave like a servant, that everything he is if there is an impediment, he help everyone to remove these impediments and tell increase the team to solve these type of issue with themselves. So Scrum Master role is very big in the team. And these are the different responsibilities, as I discussed, removing the barriers between the team and the customer. So he's the he's the bridge between the PO and the development team, teaching the customer how to maximize ROI and meet their objectives, improve the lives of the development team by facilitating creativity and empowerment. He should be responsible, humble, committed, knowledgeable, and one more quality I think which is very important is that he should be good listener. Because if he able to listen, patiently, he has to listen about the issues of the people and try to solve these issues. So these are the different quality of the Scrum Master. Now the product owner responsibility is this single person. It's not like that. It's not a team. It's a single person. And vision for what should be produced. His representative, business representative of the product owner. And he has to manage the ROI and his call for the releases. And he is also accept the user stories. So he will check all user stories on the definition of done, and then he will going to accept the user stories. Now the development team, it's there, as I suggest you, it's a cross-functional team. The programmer is there, a tester is there. If DB, then the DBs are there, then DevOps team is also the part. Nowadays, DevOps is also the part of the team. And it should be 7 people team most of the time, but plus minus 2. So maximum 9 people in the development team, and 2 more Scrum Master and POs. Size should not be more than 11 people. And the team should be self-organized and self-managed. The attributes as cross-functional with no rules, 7 plus or minus 2, responsible for commitment to work authority to do whatever is needed to meet commitment. So it's all decision will be taken by the development team, and PO or Scrum Master role should not be there. Open collected space, resolution of conflicts, rules of etiquette, motivated to deliver excellent software, motivated to improve their skills and abilities, willing to help each other and to work outside their comfort zone. So this is the quality of a development team. It's sprint planning I already discussed with you guys. Daily Scrum I already told you. Sprint review and sprint retro. So if you have any question at that time, when we in the discussion, the question answer mode, at that time we will going to discuss about these things. So these are the rules, as I told you: product owner, Scrum Master, team. Artifacts is product backlog, sprint goal, sprint backlog. Block list and increment. It's increment about the product. Project meetings is sprint planning, daily Scrum, sprint review, and sprint retrospective. These are the official meeting. But as I told you, product backlog refinement also the very important meeting or very important ceremony. Process, we already discussed, with you guys. So this is a little about Scrum. So Nitesh, over to you now. Nitesh?
Yeah, hi Shreya. Hello, can you listen to me?
Yeah, go on please.
Nitesh, are you there?
Yeah, so
yeah, I'm here.
Yeah.
Okay. So but Nitesh, we finished with the a little, you know, basic about Agile and Scrum. So I think now we will open for the open for the question answer and discussions, right?
Yeah, sure. So any of you have any question, please ask.
Okay, hi, this is Murli. It's a nice session. Can you please let me know, is there any way getting certified in Scrum? Like I have seen there are few free certification from Scrum boards somewhere I have seen. Is there any way to get certifications on this? And one more doubt I have is, what is the difference between Scrum certification and Six Sigma certification? Is it related?
No, so if you want to go for the Scrum certification, Scrum certified master, Scrum master, right? If you want to go for the Scrum master, then in this case, I will suggest you will go for the SAFe certification, because now, in fact, Scrum lines also provide certification, which is CSM certified Scrum master. But if you will go for the SAFe, which is for the scaled agile, so you will cover both two things. One, you're able to Scrum master in a Scrum team also. But if you will go for the SAFe, then scaled agile also is there, which is more relevant in these days. I think Six Sigma and SAFe, this Scrum is a little different. Nitesh, could you please elaborate about that?
Let me go into that. This is Pavan. I have a question here. Just prior to what Murli has sorry Nitesh, I'm just stopping you. Just prior to the question from Murli, I think I have been working in the Agile methodology way long, like as you mentioned. So
you can say the Agile practice
actually, right? Correct. So I think I learned this. Thank you for this session. There are many basics that got cleared. Now, if I'm into Agile practice, how can I move to the role of a Scrum Master? Is it only through the certification? Or is it anything else that I need to do?
No, you just need to understand the importance of all ceremonies, how to do these ceremonies. Actually, first of all, you have to change your mind. It's all game of mindset. We have to, move out from our comfort zone, and we try to understand what is the different benefit of Agile. So it's still in some companies and some people, they do not able to understand that what are the benefits of if we will implement Agile in our organization. So main purpose, certification is a plus for you if you will go for the certification. But the most important thing, first, you have to change your mindset. You have to change your mind to be Agile. Then only this is the benefit. So anybody can be a Scrum Master. Certification is not important, but if you will go to the certification, then you also discipline yourself and organize yourself with so many things.
Just complete this question. So Murli and Murli, thank you so much for asking. So guys, just one thing, there are different agencies which are providing certification in Scrum Master, like Scrum Alliance, there is Agile, there is a SAFe, that is Scaled Agile. So these are the different organizations who are providing certification in Scrum Master. Now again, it depends on your choice, which one you want to go, right? Whether you want to go with the Scrum Alliance, you want to go with Agile, or you want to go with the Scaled Agile, that is your choice. But if you will ask a personal opinion, we prefer to go with the Scaled Agile. Reason, because that is more in a mature certification, and that is much more in terms of the visibility, in terms of the scope they have covered. That is a in comparison to CSM, that is having a much bigger scope, right? So that we recommend. Again, it depends on your choice, which one you want to do. But nowadays, as I can see in the market, the Scrum Master positions are opening up very much in India. They are accepting Scrum Master and Agile roles very widely now. So that is the thing. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you for answering. The last question I have is, can a Scrum Master play dual roles, both Scrum Master and developer role?
Or no, is it, no, it is not recommended, recommended Murali. It's not correct. If someone, so again, this is, a game of mindset. So if you are in developing mindset, how can you be a Scrum Master? Scrum Master is a servant leader. So no, it's not suggesting, but in India, I will tell you, it's very, very common that, some QA plus Scrum Master, developer plus Scrum Master.
Yes.
But Scrum Alliance is totally against this thing. Scrum Master is PO Scrum Master.
Yeah. Basically, I'm a test automation engineer. So suppose if organization requests me to play Scrum Master role, because playing a Scrum Master role is not 8 hours productive. So I may be spending 1 hour or 1.5 hour per day, or in a Scrum I will be spending 10 hours on a Scrum Master role, and remaining productive hours I can spend either in development or test automation. So is it suggestible or not?
No, it's not suggestible, because in most of the organization a single Scrum Master will handle 2 or 3 projects, so productive hours is there. But Scrum Master is a Scrum Master, it's a different role, it's a different role. It's not it's developer, QA, these are different things. They're like, a developer is not a QA and QA is not a developer. Same. PO is something else. Business analyst is something else. As Scrum Master is something else.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah, hi, this is Viresh. Actually, you said in the certification, CSM and SAVE. So as we are, we don't have any certification. We are planning for a certification right now. So which one is suggestible? Either CSM or the SAVE?
I think Nitesh is right person to answer this question, because he's a master of these type of trainings.
Okay.
Yeah. So who asked this question?
Viresh. It's Viresh.
Okay, Viresh. Viresh. As I said before, the recommended part is that. The recommendation is that you should go for a SAVE certification, SAVE Scrum Master, right? CSM personally, I don't prefer. Although people do CSM and they come back again and do SAVE Scrum Master, right? The reason, when I compare both the courses, right? So in CSM, that's a certified Scrum Master, is having a very basic courses they have content of, right? The content is very basic, and that is good for, if I say the people should who are 6th standard and they are going to appear, they have to tell about what is a board examination, how tense they will appear. And SAVE is from basic to advanced level. That is the difference. Officially, I cannot say that you should go for a SAVE, but I can tell you that the difference between both of them, I can tell you the comparison. Personally, I have seen in the course content, SAVE is much more advanced, where it is, you can say, Scrum of Scrum. So that gives you knowledge of Scrum plus Scrum of Scrum. It is the roles and responsibility and how the matured organization are working on that. And I have seen in my personal that if there is any requirement for a Scrum Master, so, and people who are CSM and SAVE certified has applied for that. Preference has been given to people who are SAVE certified.
Okay, so actually my query is so instead of doing CSM, if you go directly to the SAVE, that is advanced as of now, that can be acceptable in the market?
Yes, there is. Okay. The basic condition for doing a SAVE or CSM is that you should having some knowledge about that, right?
Yeah. I'm holding 9 years of experience into QA, working in Agile methodology from past 5 years. So I'm planning for the certification actually. So I have in a dilemma like whether I have to do the CSM or any advanced.
Yeah. So you can connect me. I mean, if you are in the same channel, you can connect me individually, right?
Sure.
I will let you know which one is better, and I will share a few links with you where you can go and compare different certification of for a Scrum Master.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, thanks very much.
Or any of you, if you want more detail on that, I have a few good links which will help you to understand the different certification in Scrum Master.
Yeah, hi Ankit this side.
Ankit.
Yeah, actually my concern is that we are working on short term project like 6 months or 8 months, maybe maximum 1 year. So is it suggestible to go with if someone new project is coming? So can you recommend as a QA to the client we can go for Agile or something like that?
So who was asking this question?
Ankit.
Yeah, so Ankit, it's again depend on the project. If we can recommend for any type of project, even we will go for the Agile or Scrum. But only in this case that where the requirement is very much clear to the client that he wants this type of project only, there is no change might be in the future, then only we will go for the waterfall model. Otherwise, in the current scenario, any project can be go with the Agile Scrum.
Okay, so just in our organization we are doing the QA part of the project. So if the Agile, we need to include all the QA and developer, so might be the developer are from other organizations, so it will be little bit critical to implement the Agile in this
No, Ankit, this is not a issue in now right now in the scenario, because in the current scenarios the teams are in the different geography. Some people, the developer team might be in the US and the testing team is in the India or in somewhere else, and the DBA team somewhere else, but still their team that the people work in the Agile method in the Scrum or in the Kanban. There is no issues, but in this case we have to keep in mind that the communication should be very tight. So we can work in the Agile way of working. There is no issues if the team is in distributed. The team is in distributed way. There are no issues if in the different places team is available.
Okay. And one more question. And is there any tools where we need to keep the track of our sprint, how to progress in, means how much?
So Jira we can use. So Jira, Rally. There are so many tools, ALM tools which we can use.
ALM tools are available. So apart from that, is there any specific tools where we need to keep our update our products like backlog or the product which we need to include in our sprint or like that?
I think Jira is the good tool because Jira is the good one compared to Rally. So we'll go with the Jira. You can use Jira.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Hi Shreyas, Khushbu
Dhirani. Yes, Khushbu.
I have a question. What is sprint backlog and product backlog?
So sprint product backlog is that when we start our project, in this case the product owner will discuss with the client about the requirements. Accordingly, he will create, first of all, he will create some epic, and on these epics he will create the user stories to understand that for the particular epic what type of requirement is there, and on this requirement he will create the user stories, and these user stories he will keep in the backlog, and this backlog is called the product backlog. And when we will do the sprint planning, first we will create the sprint backlog where we will discuss about the user stories. We will do the sizing and estimation for the user stories. And if we know that you understand about the sizing, this is where we will give the user story points to the user story. So if we know the velocity of the team, like if your team is able to finish only 40 user story points in a sprint, and sprint backlog is there, and you will give user story points your to your backlog, and might be the size is 60 or 70. So you ready with your backlog, but you're able to finish only 40. So rest of the thing, you will move back to the product backlog, and whatever user story is left, which on which we are going to work. So your sprint backlog, when you pull your user stories on which you want to work, and product backlog, where your you know, product owner will create user stories for the development. Right?
Right. Thank you.
Yeah, hi, this is Mitesh. Hello.
Yes, Mitesh.
Yeah, hi. So my question is, so you have mentioned that we can use different frameworks with Agile. So I would like to know what are the different frameworks and how we can use them with the Agile practice during our Agile.
Right. As I discussed with you, with Scrum, we already discussed that it's a framework. Then Kanban is there. Right, in Kanban, most of the time when we use, when we will in the phase of the, you know, enhancement or the maintain part, or in the support type of project, where you know we can use the Kanban framework. It's a little different from the Scrum. It's worked totally different way compared to the Scrum. Then you know, we will move to the scaled Agile part. Extreme programming is also there. Then we will move to the scaled Agile part, where the size, the you know, the team size is very big. It's around 60-70 people. Because I already discussed with you guys, the Scrum team should not be more than 11 people, where 9 is the people in the development team. One is Scrum Master, another one is the PO. But if the team size is more than 60 or 70, in this case, we have to create 7 or 8 teams. In this case.
Okay.
Discuss Scrum, scaled Agile is in the picture. So there is so many like common Kanban there. There are so many different type of skills. Safe, another one is the dead, and Spotify also in the picture now. You know, this is for the songs and everything. So they have follow their other type of scaled Agile. So these are different things. So you have to go through with every. Right, guys, anything else?
Just one more question. If you can tell me, like, the user stories are written by a product owner only, or BSA do also write the
user? No, anybody can write user stories. There is development team is also able to write user stories. But one thing is there. If anybody else other than PO will going to write the user stories, he has to take approval from the PO that user story is correct or not. Right, but yes, PO, yeah. Most of the time PO, but anybody can write the user story.
Okay, thank you, Shreya. Thank you so much.
Hi, Abhishek. So I have a question, like someone is new with this Agile and Scrum. So is there any hierarchy who one can follow to learn this Agile and Scrum?
Which way? I didn't get you. Hierarchy meaning first what we are going to learn, then another skill, right?
Yeah, right.
It's not like that. First of all, you have to understand about the Agile. What is Agile? Because all framework will work on the Agile values and principles. So first of all, you have to understand what is Agile, and then you will try to understand different frameworks. So I will suggest to you, first you will go to the Agile. What is Agile? How this will work? What is the lean process? That like lean processes work on the PDCA concept, where we say that plan, then PCDA concept, in which we suggest that first you have to plan, then you have to develop, then you have to check, and accordingly you have to adjust. So every time this learning phase is going on. So this we include in the Agile, where after iteration we have to learn, okay, we are in the right direction or not. So this is the way. First you have to learn about the Agile, and then you try to learn about the different frameworks. So I think so you have to go for the SAFe. If you'll go for the SAFe, then Scrum plus SAFe, you will be able to learn both of the frameworks.
Okay, thank you.
So I think Nitesh is almost.
Yeah.
We are.
So, any of you having any more question to ask Abhishek, Ankit, Ashish, push and joy.
I have one question. I just want to know the basic difference between epic and user story. Can you explain me with an example so I can easily understand it?
Okay, so epic is a thought, you know, epic is a thought in the mind of the customer. For example, customer want to, there is a thought that, okay, I will, develop this type of car, like for Ratan Tata. Like, okay, I will going to, develop, to manufacture the Indy car. So this is a thought. Right, and then the different feature will be there. Like if you want to develop, you want to manufacturing a car. So this is the big picture. Now, what are the different feature is there that you have to buy some land, then you have to construct your factory there. Then, you have to discuss with the different vendors that some vendors will make this part, some will make this part, and in your factory where you manufacturing your car, you have to assemble your car, and then you have to go to the market, you have to develop your market strategy, how you will going to sell your car in the market, or Indica, for example. So the epic is the thought, the bigger thought, like we have to manufacturing this type of car, and the feature are these are the different features. Like we have to go to buy the land, then this we have to assemble this. These are the factories, and the user stories. You know, it's a very simple part. Like if we will going to assemble our car, then on which we were going to write for user stories. This part will come from this vendor. This part will come from this vendor. Accordingly, finally, we will able to develop manufacturing. So epic, you can say it's a big user story, and for which we will going to break these user stories in small user stories, and we will work on these small user stories. So epic is a thought on in which feature is there, and then this feature will break in the user stories.
Okay. Right. So epic and user story both are written by the product owner, or epic story is written by
epic, right. Actually, BA is also there. So epic is the thought of customer, and in epic, feature will be developed by the BA. BA will help to understand that what customer actually wants. It's just a thought, but if for example, why BA is there? Because they are expert in this type of thing. Like if there is a banking application, BA will help if there is some gap.
Yeah,
so he will fill this gap, and then PO will be in the picture to create the user story, and after understanding what is the project.
Okay, fine.
And the size of the user story. So size of the story which we will achievable in a single sprint. It's not like that a user story will move to the another sprint also. So we will make this much of a small the user story, right?
Okay. So my question is, we have the use cases. So those use cases are derived from these user stories.
Right. From these user stories, right.
Yeah, and the QA will write those test case, use cases, or product owner.
QA is not in the picture. QA will work on the QA is the part of the development team, and you have in user stories their acceptance criteria is there, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and on these acceptance criteria, QA has to work. So he has to check this acceptance criteria. So QA, moreover, to check that acceptance criteria is matching or not. So okay. I think PO will be the part of this thing, right?
Okay. Thanks. Thank you,
guys. So Nitesh, rest of the okay. Hi.
Yes, I have one question.
Okay. KD.
Yeah. Okay. My question was, when we get the requirements from the customer, we create the backlog. Then how do we prioritize backlogs?
So it's again depend on the epic. If there is 4-5-6 epic is there, and you will create user stories on these epics, right? and PO will with the discussion with the client, and which epic is the most important one, on which epic client want to see that how is going to develop. Accordingly, you will create user stories to your accordingly your epic. So whatever epic is more important, the user stories highest priority we will give to the user stories. And other than, there is so many method. Moscow is there, which is a must have, could have, should have method. Kiro mm-hmm. method is there. There are so many other method, but again, this is depend on the client discussion, a PO, and between the stakeholders on which type of user stories or which epic they want first, and accordingly PO will prioritize your backlog, and accordingly you will create your sprint backlog and sprint, you will plan your sprint, right?
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you.
So I think we have to finish. It's almost 1 hour now. And if you guys have any question, please ping Nitesh. We'll try to give answer as much as possible. Right, Nitesh?
Yeah. You guys can ping in same group where you are added. So thank you so much. Sorry for this wonderful session. I hope everyone has got some information, some basic or advanced. You have cleared the doubts, and you have knowledge about Scrum and Agile. It was a wonderful session. I will just request that you just share your feedback on Google. Right, just type refer me group and share your feedback. That will help us to.
Is it possible to share the presentation to the members who joined this call?
Yeah, surely. After, I mean, tomorrow when we will finish, then we will share it. So just share your feedback. Then after that, we have also planned that we will circulate one quiz for you guys. So that will help you more to understand about Agile, right? So thank you so much, guys, for joining this wonderful session. Again, thank you so much to Shaurya for this amazing and very knowledgeable session. Have a good day. Take care. Good night.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.